Today, we're pitting muscle cars against imports.
Which of these cars are gonna use to take these suckers down? Whoever wins moves on to the race for $10,000.
I kick his ass! What is he doing?
We got a little surprise for you.
You got it!
What'd you do? Did you bump him?
For generations, race fans have wondered which is faster, American muscle or imports. So on a stretch of winding asphalt, we issue the challenge. I'm John Reeve, and this is my Mullet Mafia. We say good old American muscle can beat imports any day. So I'm putting my money where my mouth is, with 3 rounds of racing and 10 grand at stake. All you gotta prove is...
We're deep in the heart of real America. Capital of Redneck Racing, Kershaw, South Carolina, where we're fixing to spend another day whooping on imports. There'll be 3 rounds of racing today. It's good old American muscle versus imports. And if the imports are faster than a redneck, they'll go home with $10,000 of my money. In this first round, we're throwing open the gates and inviting anyone who's got an import to come in and try to outrace a redneck.
Before we get out there and blow these punks out of the water,
me and my boys want to walk the line first and size them up a bit. This college boy here is Jeremy, John Reap, and he brought a Nissan. How many horsepowers does a wiener dog have?
Right around 500 to the wheels.
No, zero.
Incorrect.
I think we found our first customer. Cha-ching!
I'm not sure if you're going to be driving a Dodge truck, a farm tractor, whatever they bring to the track, but I plan on showing them what the import can do for sure.
The rules of round one are simple. The first 2 import drivers who win a race against a redneck move on to round 2. All 3 rounds of racing today will begin with a 35-mile-an-hour rolling start, less wear and tear on the cars. And this first round will only be a 1-lap race, so everyone's got to come out the hole like a madman. First on deck, Jeremy in the red GTR versus the Rattlers 2012 Mustang.
It's time to see what we're up against.
Saying the Rattler lost is an understatement.
Come on, Rattlesnake!
Right. This Jeremy kid spanked him like a newborn. Shameful, really. So now Mr. Red Nissan's moving on to the next round.
Lucky bastard.
Listen, I know you cheated. What'd you do? You got a flux capacitor?
No, just import power for you, bud.
Import power. At first, I was depressed on account of the Rattler lost. So hopefully he can redeem himself against this tin can.
Oh. Rattlesnake!
The Subaru lost. There's one punk down.
Not fast enough!
And that set off a redneck stomping spree. First, we stomped on the little Miata. Look at that, of course it's gonna lose. It's like teal. Then we stomped on that little silver pretzel muncher.
Good job, good job.
Another victory for the rednecks. Shocker. Here's Anthony. He loves his car so much that he brought it on its own trailer. How sweet. Well, he better have some skill, because he's going up against Yancey in the 2010 Camaro. No contest.
All right, here we go.
What an idiot. Rubbin's part of racing, but what he did there, that's just dirty poop. I bet you feel really happy right now.
I feel awesome, man.
Well, what'd you do? Did you bump him?
You know what? I had position in that turn, and he couldn't slow down.
Congratulations. You're going on to the next round.
Thanks,
you won't be so lucky next time. Get out of here. I see Yancey do that, and I'm in shock. That's not just Bush League. That's like Kurt Busch League.
That BMW driver definitely does not know what a line is. And to drive right into somebody needs a good ass kick.
Look, I know there's 10K of my money on the line here, but we don't have to be dicks about it. So I'm DQing Yancey for the rest of the day. That's it. He's out. Final decision.
Well, it looks like 2 preppies won, so we have to go talk to him.
Oh, hell no.
A BMW.
A BMW. Look at it. It's already got a big dent inside of it.
That's the car that's going to kick your ass on the track.
Yeah, right.
My name's Anthony. I'm from Florence, Kentucky, and I'm an automotive engineer. I've got a BMW M3 E46, and it's stripped out. It's got good suspension, tires. The car does its job.
You guys owe me $4,000. Now I gotta take your $10,000 so I can fix this.
What? We don't owe you.
I don't think they really knew what they were looking at. They have never seen carbon fiber before.
Oh no, that's carbon fiber.
You guys wouldn't know anything about that. It's a space age material.
Thanks, Jetsons.
So they don't even know what they're gonna be up against.
We'll see you on the track, loser.
Loser.
Looky here, a Nissan GTR. Well, let's see if we can scratch the red
line. Guys,
don't
be touching the car, getting it all greasy.
My name's Jeremy. I'm a director of marketing and sales for Southside Performance. We're located in Houston, Texas. I have a 2010 Nissan GTR, twin turbocharged 3.8 liter V6, tons of suspension, lots of aero, and lots of power. I don't think they really knew what was going on with my car. They didn't know what the car was to begin with.
It's just an overrated Datsun.
That's right.
Oh, it's like a wiener dog.
If I win the $10,000, I'm gonna, you know, save a little bit of money for a wedding that I have coming up and pay some bills off, basically.
Guys, what do you say we go figure out what we're gonna use to beat this piece of crap?
Yeah. You're gonna need to come up with something real, real good.
American muscle, yeah, son. Yeah. Right here.
Import muscle here, bud.
Okay, hey, keep your britches on,
yeah,
prepping.
We'll do, bud. We'll do.
We'll be
see
back.
You on the track.
All right, guys, help me out. We gotta get serious here. Which of these cars are we gonna use to take these suckers down?
Put the Challenger out there. I think I can match his arrow.
Well, it's a 09 Dodge Challenger. I built it myself. Of course, it's got the Hemi in it. It's got a lot of power. It's also got a lot of weight. But I don't know anything else I'd rather run.
Anybody else?
Let's throw out the green grenade, and I'll pull the pin on their ass.
Yeah, baby. Yes.
Oh, the 69 Green Camaro, I mean, it's a weapon. LS7 engine, 600 horsepower, full Detroit speed. I mean, that thing is just an awesome car.
Pull out the Terlingua Mustang.
You serious?
I'm serious.
All right, buddy. Boom!
That car is a throwback to salute Carroll Shelby and his Terlingua race team that raced SCCA back in the 60s.
So we got three monsters to put up against these imports, and now these punks get to choose which one they want to race. You guys ready?
Ready. Yeah.
What are you looking at me for? Let's go. Come on. I want you to listen to this. That's the sound of red, white, and blue right there.
Woo! We had a surprise.
We've been racing all morning trying to show these two preppies how much imports suck when put up against real American muscle. They made it to round two so far. This is where the fun begins. So here we are, round two of Redneck Racing. Now, you each are gonna get a go-around with one of our all-American vehicles. Whoever wins moves on to the race for $10,000. All right, boys, open sesame! Each one of these cars is gonna put a hurting on you, okay? You get the honor of choosing which one. So, Anthony, you had the best track time, so we're gonna let you go first, all right? Pick your poison, buddy.
This one here kinda hurts my eyes, so I don't think I'm gonna go with that.
I don't wanna run against a yellow car because it's yellow. It's one of the dumbest things I've ever heard in my life.
This one here looks like an active race car. I think I'm gonna eliminate that one. So, I'm gonna go with the car that's got the interior.
What?
I don't know what it is.
You're gonna go with the Camaro?
Camaro, is that what it is? All right.
When he picked that, I was screaming inside because that is the one car that I did not want to go up against.
Did you hear that, Brian? Crank it up, let's do this. I want you to listen to this.
That was a huge mistake on his part. He didn't know that that was the fastest car in that group.
That's the sound of red, white, and blue right there.
I've developed the handling on the car, and I know how to drive it to the limit. So with me behind the wheel, these guys are not gonna stand a chance.
You ready? Let's roll out. Let's get to racing, boys. Round two is officially off. And if you remember, the races will begin with a rolling start, but there's three laps this time. So now we find out who can really drive. Looks like we got a 2001 Beamer M3 versus the Redneck Grenade, AKA 69 Camaro. Now that's what I call kick ass. I'm here in the booth with Ken Squire for the first semifinal race.
And welcome, America, to Carolina Motorsports Park, Kershaw, South Carolina, joined by John Reap to bring us the action today. You ready,
big guy? I am ready. I am pumped.
Now, the competitor here is someone that I presume you know.
My man,
Ryan. If you want to have a fight, this is the guy you want to have a fight with.
Yeah, baby.
He is tough.
There's just a big can of Finch whoop ass coming right now.
The green flag has been flown. And the Camaro is in the lead like I planned it.
Look at that battle up in front. Wheel to wheel, side by side into that corner.
Woo! Oh, we hit some dirt.
Yeah, a little dust bowl.
Come on, Brian Finch. Do it for the Camaros. Do it for America.
Well, he may throw it away here if he's not a little more careful. Here they come. Up on that big, fast, super turn. It's car against car, man against man, and the duel continues for three laps in each of these events.
Looking good, Brian, looking good.
Come get you some.
Brian is still in the lead. Looks like he's up by like 5-6 car lengths.
Boy, he puts it right on the edge. Look at that line through turns one and two.
Come on, Brian, final lap, baby. Well, he nails it. He just stands on it in those straightaways. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, he's so far ahead, I'm getting a little tingle in my dingle, if you know what I'm talking about.
In the final moments of this one.
This is it. Final straightaway. Coming down. Go, baby. Go, baby. Woo!
130 mile an hour plus as he crosses the line.
My man.
Give it to Brian Finch of Nashville, Tennessee.
Another victory for the good guys, Ken.
Number one, baby, I told you.
Up top, high five. Let's do it. You can do a high five or a fist bump.
Yeah. Woo! That's what I'm talking about.
Did a little redneck ass whooping out there is what we done.
Yeah, nice job, Brian. Thank you, sir. Come on, up top. Yeah. Congratulations for losing.
I gave it all I had. Car did its job. Ultimately, it just didn't have enough horsepower.
You've got to pick your poison. Are you ready?
I'm ready to do
it.
Let's
get out of here.
Let's go.
Come on, son. Yeah.
That leaves two cars left, okay? Two of our American muscle cars and your hunk of cow manure. Pick your poison, son.
Well, I'm not going to go with the Challenger here because that just looks like an absolute all-out track beast with a ton of aero. So I'm going to have to go with the yellow Mustang.
Ooh, you go with the Tang, huh?
I am.
Yellow Mustang.
Mustang looked the most tame out of all the cars. It was just a bright yellow Mustang with a cage in it.
Lonnie, did you hear that?
We're about to fry your catfish, son.
Yeah, we'll
crank her up, Lonnie. I want you to listen to this.
Let's see if it starts first. The Mustang actually didn't sound all that impressive. It was just noise.
What's noise, brother?
I have no idea what kind of skills Jeremy has. I don't care. We'll just see what he's got on the track.
Let's get to racing. Noise. Come on, let's go. Woo!
We got a little surprise for you.
Well, we're halfway through three rounds of muscle versus import racing, and so far only Jeremy and his Nissan are still standing. But that can all change right here, because if he can't win this next race, he might just be going home. You ready, Lonnie?
I'm ready, man.
All right.
Your funeral, sucker. We're looking at a 2010 Nissan GTR against a 68 Terlanga Mustang. Keep your overalls on. This is about to get good.
At Carolina Motorsports Park in Kershaw, South Carolina, with John Reap, I'm Ken Squire. This is a good one. The yellow car is the Mustang, and the other car is this state-of-the-art Nissan. This is a video game on four wheels. All right, who is faster than a redneck? We're about to find out.
Woo, hopefully nobody.
Lottie's gonna put it to him.
Here comes the green flag, and they're off.
Drag race, and look at that Nissan yank out in front.
No! Yeah!
Here they come for that tough 90-degree turn.
Come on, Lottie!
Into turn one, quickly up to turn two.
Come on,
I'm telling you, that little Nissan, 60 miles an hour in about 1.27 seconds.
My
thing is incredible.
Yeah, and look at it, pulls to these corners. Fair. But now we're getting into that longer straightaway.
Come on, Lonnie.
Come on, Lonnie.
And Lonnie may be able to overwhelm him right here.
Hang on.
What are you doing?
I think this is over.
It's not over. It just started when the first lap.
It's all right. It's all right. It ain't over yet.
I'm rooting.
The Nissan is out in front. The Mustang, here it comes in the longest portion of the track. This big straightaway, this drag strip.
Pass me that salt.
One moment,
I'm like
salt
on my watermelon.
Keep going. Keep going.
All right, so they're around in the second lap. We're about one and a half of the way through. Why don't you discuss Jeremy Roars, native of Baltimore, who's putting it to it right there.
I know.
Beautiful
it's
machine.
It's disgusting to look at.
3.8 twin turbo V6. When you light that puppy up coming off a corner, you'd better have it straight or it'll find its own way off the course. That's a very good driver.
One more.
We are in the final lap.
All right.
And Jeremy Roars, R-O-H-R-S, is F-A-S-T fast.
I think I made the wrong choice. The yellow car is pretty slow.
Oh, I see you lapping.
This is it right here?
Yeah, it's getting close.
It's
There's
over.
The checkers are out.
Boom.
Well, it's a big victory for Europeans, that's for sure.
It's embarrassing.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Look at you. Somehow you snuck into the finals. You win this race, you're going home 10 grand richer. Then I got news for you. Not gonna happen.
Jeremy got to pick the car he wanted to race against last go-around, but this time it's my choice. I can't wait to see the look on his stupid face.
You ready to meet him?
Let's see it.
All right, release the Kraken! Oh, looky, looky. The year 169 Camaro is top to bottom made in the USA muscle. It's got 600 horses under the hood and enough torque to choke a mule three times. It's the kind of car that keeps tuners up at night. You hear that? Skitter, ain't it?
Getting nervous yet?
Drum roll, please.
We pulled out the 69 number 3 Camaro, and the surprise was...
Any guesses? Nothing.
Dale Earnhardt Jr., who do you got under there?
Drum roll, please. Can you guess who it is?
Dale Earnhardt Jr., who do you got under there?
Shakalaka! Oh, hey. May I present to you Bo Duke right there, Jesus. One of the fastest rednecks in TV history, the king of rednecks, John Schneider.
Yeah! I knew they had some trick up their sleeve after I beat up on the last two guys, and I didn't know who was coming out of that suit, but he pulled the helmet off and my jaw hit the floor.
That's what we're talking about.
I think there's a chance I can do well, and if not, I'll put on a show.
My brain's like, holy crap, I just met Bo Duke. And then the other part's like, holy crap, I gotta race him.
We'll see.
Round three is once again a rolling start and three laps of racing. But this time, this punk has a shot at 10 grand. So for the final $10,000 race, I give you the 2010 Nissan GTR versus Bo Duke in the 69 Camaro. It don't get much better than this. All right, here we go.
All right, we're down to it. This is the biggie.
I'm nervous, man. I gotta tell you, you got the legendary, the one and only Bo Duke defending $10,000 of my cash. This is a dream come true for me, Ken. I gotta tell you.
And for the rest of the world, John Schneider is driving the black number 3.
Breaker 19, Bo. This here's a cooter you got here, so come on.
Here we go, down to it.
Get on it, Bo!
Oh, my heart.
Oh, wow, that Nissan just took off, didn't it?
Come on, Nissan boy. Said, I'm departing, see you on another planet. That thing is Godzilla.
Comes from
another world.
Come on.
There they are around the first turn, and now they've got a new challenge. Sun, straighten their eyes as they go down this 800-foot straightaway that leads up into turn number 3.
Come on,
look at this margin already. as they come around through that big wide sweeper on the far end of this just about 9/10 of a mile course.
It's okay, this company's vehicle. Come on.
Here comes Schneider, alias Bo Duke.
Yes.
At number three.
Maybe if I just start doing the horn, Dixie.
I don't think we need that.
Will that
either.
Help him?
No.
That only works if he's jumping over a river.
Ooh.
Camaro. Oh, no!
The American car just does a 360.
Oh, come on! He said screw it. It's over. Come on!
Just getting my 10 grand.
Time to cut across.
Time to cut across.
Johnson's crossing. Johnson's crossing. You remember it.
Take Bo, your $10,000.
This is my money, Bo.
He's going!
Boy, you talk about a shortcut.
Come on! What is he doing?
Well, I think he's having a very good time.
He's pissing me off, Kim.
Well,
this is $10,000 of my money.
It's the king of the rednecks.
I'm going to have to cancel my Hawaii trip now.
You can't cancel the performance of that Nissan. $10,000 right in the pocket of Jeremy Roars. Yeah. Don't go down there and be sour.
How would you feel if you just lost 10 grand of your own cash? You'd be a little pissed off too, kid. Damn it!
Jeremy Roars has done it.
Woo! That's what I'm talking about. Kicking some redneck ass.
I think I put on a good show. But I didn't win. I didn't win.
I couldn't find my ass with both hands.
Once I had the advantage in turn one, it was over with after that.
It absolutely kills me to hand over my money, but I can be a good sport about it.
$10,000 U.S. American dollars.
Right out of your backyard, huh?
Don't spend it in one place. Well, I hate to say it, Jeremy, but I guess you are faster than a redneck. Let's give him a round of applause, guys. Good sport.
$10,000 beating up on Bo Duke. You know, I mean, short of him having the General Lee out there, I don't know what could have topped this, but it's absolutely awesome. Awesome day.
$10,000, I'm gonna have one hell of a honeymoon. That's all I gotta say.
This don't prove nothing, by the way, okay? A tuner was bound to win at some point. That's just the odds. We'll lick our wounds, we'll come back, and we'll show these tuners what's what. And besides,
I let him win.